Okay, so I've got my number here from the Xbox upstairs. I'm now going to enter it here in the media center downstairs where my main PC is. I'm going to go over to the task menu. I'm going to go to add extender. And it tells me what I need to do in order to connect the two devices, and then it starts to ask me for the code that I had from upstairs, so I'm going to enter that here. 9916-2283. And then hit next. At this point, the computer starts to change some of its own settings in order to accommodate for the extender. It asks me if I want to be able to make the media folders, which are here on my PC, available to the extender. Most cases you would say yes, because you want to be able to transmit all the content you have here over. In this case, I'm just gonna say no, just because of the ease of setup. Click on next. Because it's Vista, it'll ask me to continue. And then it goes ahead and starts searching for the extender. It's found the extender at this point, and now it's going to start all by itself configuring the PC for the extender settings. So we just need to wait for a moment while it goes ahead and checks the rest of these boxes right here. So then you're allowed to tune your network. This goes back to the other segment we talked about, the various types of network performance you can expect to see and some of the limitations in the house. In this case, I'm going to say no, I'm not going to run the network performance tuner at this point. But if you run into problems with interference, then it's something you might want to take a look at. And it says you are done, and go ahead and finish. Okay, at this point we can go back upstairs. The two devices should now be connected to each other, and we'll be able to go and see the TV content distributed wirelessly in the bedroom.